Students, I am Satish Khanna. I am working under the Assistant Professor of Marine Department in Amit University. Today topic, I am going to take the topic is an emergency generator on ships. Before going to our topic, we must know about the basics of the power generation and distribution on ships. So, this is the main black diagram of our ship power distribution on ship. This is the entire circuit electric diagram of the ship power distribution. That is in the ship, mostly according to the SOLAS regulation, we have an three to four generators, depends upon our requirement of the ships. Here there is an only a two generator and one emergency generator. The two main generator which connected on the main switchboard, the two generator are connected on the main switchboard. From the main switchboard, the power will be distributed to the distribution to the various load. Okay. And also there is another alternate generator is the emergency generator. Today I am seeing about this topic only. This emergency generator also coupled with the main generator in the main switchboard. But when we are used means when the power cut off or due to any blackout situation, the main switchboard we have the power will be cut off on that seconds on the frequency of the next second, the main emergency generator will be power on and give the supply to the main supply. And not for the entire ship, they give some of the important load from the emergency generator. We must know about the how much of the voltage will be generated depends upon the ship. Depends upon our power requirement, we have generated the huge megawatt of the various megawatts of the ship. For example, the various of the ships we are used, the first one is a cargo ship. Normally the general cargo ship which has a power requirement 1 megawatt, and next one the tanker. For the tanker ship we have an 1.5 to 5 megawatt, and for the container ship we have an 8 megawatt, and then modern LNG carrier which is a 6.6 kV for 12 megawatt. So generally our normal ships are very used only a 6.6 kVA power generation in the main switchboard by using the 2 or 3 generators. From this picture, we can see about the simple black diagram, it is an interrelated relationship between the main generator and the emergency generator. So, the main generator get the supply from the diesel which has a 6.6 kV. I am already said generally our ships are generated there 6.6 kV. So, that supply will be goes to the main switchboard. From that main switchboard, the transformer will be stepped down and go to the auxiliary switchboard for the non-essential services. What is the non-essential services means? For the air conditioner, fan, like that. Then from that switchboard, the supply directly go to the emergency switchboard. There is also the interlock between the both main switchboard and the emergency switchboard. And there is another source from the emergency generator to the emergency switchboard. So this is the main switchboard, this is an emergency switchboard. From the switchboard only we get the supply to the load. Okay. But the source of the main switchboard is a main diesel generator, and the source of the emergency switchboard is an emergency generator. So what's our point means, today we can see about only the emergency generator and the emergency switchboard. Where we are here used means when the power cut off, when the main switchboard the power will be cut off, the automatically the next 3 or 45 seconds the emergency generator will be in on and the supply goes to the emergency switchboard, and remaining time there is a supply from the main switchboard to the emergency switchboard only. When the supply will be cut off, the emergency generator on, and the there is an interlock will be closed between the two main switchboard and emergency switchboard will be open, and this interlock will be in closed between the emergency generator and the emergency switchboard. This is the main working operation. We can see detail in our next slide. So what is the emergency generator? We want to know about the definition of the emergency generator. So it's a small separate generator which supplies the electric power for emergency load in the event of main power supply failure. It's a very important event of main supply failure. So emergency generator work only when the main generator will be in failure. On the condition only emergency generator will be in on, and another time this only in the standstill condition only. And it's located in the outside of the main and auxiliary machinery space. Why? Because we want the emergency generator in a very secure manner. So we must give, we place the emergency generator in a separate from the main switchboard. If any power loss or any fire accident or any uncircumstanced situation will be come, did not disturbance any emergency generator, because the emergency generator supply will go for the very important load. So we are not to protect that important load, we give the emergency generator in a separate places only. So it is located outside the main and auxiliary machinery space and not forward of the collision bulkhead, and where well engine room is highly prone to fire and other factors. So protect from the uncircumstances situations. And it has an own switchboard and near in a vicinity. So there is a separate switchboard, there is an emergency switchboard for distribute the load for the emergency generator. And also it provided with independent means of automatically starting. So the starting of the emergency generator also very very important. We must know about the starting of the emergency generator. It's not like the normal main generator. Normally the main generator we are run on in 24 hours, they are in run only. But in initial state there is some various process for starting the main generator. For our emergency generator there is three types of the starting, we see about the next slides. So this is a very important for starting the emergency generator, because start means in critical situation only. So without any pressure, without any tension, we want to operate the emergency generator. So we must know about the well-known about the starting of emergency generator. So it's provided the independent means of automatically starting ARR battery to ensure the immediate run up following a main power failure, and repeated start of at least 3 times and further attempt can be made within 30 minutes. So we are start the, when we have power failure, we are used to attempt to start the emergency generator in the at least in 3 times. An adequate independent supply of the fuel with the flash point of not less than 40 degrees Celsius. So the fuel of the flash point in emergency generator, the fuel of the fuel given to the emergency generator, that flash point is not less than 40 degrees Celsius. Because only if the less than 40 degrees Celsius means it's not sufficient to start immediately. So we must maintain the fuel point, the flash point, not less than the 40 degrees Celsius. And also in cold condition it's up to zero degrees Celsius also. So it's a pictorial diagram of the emergency generator in a ship. This is the entire construction of the emergency generator. There is a power supply, the power output is come from the, we are taken from this main switchboard. Before starting we must check the voltage frequency between the main switchboard, and there is a tank inside, the oil will be filled, there is an engine will be backside, and there is a starting process. We are discuss about the, how they started and the entire construction in the next slide. So before going to our emergency generator, we must know about the maintenance. So every cadet in a ship, in every Saturday emergency generator must be test run, because the emergency generator we are only used in one under circumstance situation only. So it's been rare. As a good engineer, the emergency generator will be never be work by our maintenance the main switchboard, main generator. By any accidental situation will occur means we only that time only we are use the emergency generator. So on the time we are used in 45 seconds the emergency generator to be in operate. So we want to be in emergency generator in pakka manner, in a clear manner. That's why It's under the rule of the shipping, DG shipping. Every Saturday, the ship cadets are go to test the emergency generator for normal test condition. And the air before going to the testing the emergency generator, the air bottle pressed up or starter battery fully charged at all time. So because the emergency generator start by the one of the starting method is in battery. So that the battery to be in fully charged. And the change over the selector switch to local position before starting. What is the change over position switch means? There's a switch, there's an, I can already said, they said there is an interlock switch between the main switchboard and then emergency switchboard. There's a connection between the main switchboard and then emergency switchboard. In normal time, normal condition, the power supply for main emergency switchboard come from the main switchboard. Okay. During an accidental condition only, that main switchboard is being off and the power given to the emergency switchboard come from the emergency generator. On that time, the switch will be in off condition, here the switch will be in on condition. So, this on off situation conducted by the changeover. So, before going to test our emergency generator, we must change over the switch from the main switchboard. And make sure the breaker switch at off position before starting. I have already said no, that interlock between the emergency main switchboard breaker and the emergency switchboard breaker is provided to prevent the simultaneous closure of the both breaker. So very very important, before going to the test the emergency generator on Saturday, we must, before going to start the emergency generator, we must switch off the position of the starting method in the interlock switch. During the test, after the switch off the main switchboard, that using that interlock switch, then we check the voltage, frequency and the ampere. That means the voltage rating and frequency rating and ampere rating, it under in control or not. Okay. Next, the fuel tank, it also be checked to ensure the adequate level. We have an adequate level of the fuel, we are in full manner. So we first check out the level of the fuel. If the level will be reduced when we start, means there is no use of the starting of the emergency generator. Next, the air filter of the generator regularly cleaned. So in every Saturday we must clean the air filter, so to prevent from the dust. And the required tools and spares kept in a container. In required places, we ever change the places of the tools and spares. I can repeat that emergency generator working under the pressure situation, that means in emergency situation, so we can tackle that problem very nicely and very cool, means we kept the tools and spare on that place and we check and we have a proper maintenance on every Saturday, means it's very easy. Otherwise it's very trouble on the emergency situation. And the emergency light for the room should be always checked. So the light is very important in the deck. In the engine room, there's a light is important. Without light, there's an all are in dark. So the emergency light is always in on condition. Next, we briefly say about the emergency switchboard. So I already said the emergency generator generates the voltage. Okay, that voltage will be goes to the emergency switchboard. From the emergency switchboard only the load to be distributed. The generator which generates the power and the switchboard which distribute the power. Okay, so emergency switchboard which distribute the emergency load, that power supplied from the emergency generator during the main power source failure. And it has in two section, the main switchboard, sorry, the emergency switchboard which is classified into two section, one for 440 volt and for 220 volt. The 440 three phase load are connected from the 440 sides, and the minor load like lighting, steering gear, like that lower voltage are connected on the 220 volt. Why they are separated means for easy maintenance and maintain the backup. We need only a 220 volt, means just we connected only 220. If we on the or other we are connected on both, means there is a lot of losses, fuel loss and then power loss. That's why they are easily separated. When the power is lost, the circuit breaker is tripped and the emergency generator comes into action and supply power through another circuit breaker. And there is an interlock, I am already said the interlock is provided to prevent the simultaneous closing of both breaker. So there is an interlock, it's a very very important device is an interlock. This interlock is a device which is connected between main switchboard and the emergency switchboard, which prevents simultaneously the closing of the both breaker, both main and emergency generator, by running simultaneously. Because in when emergency generator when we run, the supply from the main switchboard will be in cutoff only. We are in testing condition. There's an emergency supply. There's the emergency switchboard. We get the supply from main switchboard and also from the emergency generator. The both supply come to the emergency switchboard means it's very dangerous to them, that emergency switchboard. That's why we must check in and cooperate the interlock between the two circuit breaker. There is a circuit breaker which connected from the main switchboard to the emergency switchboard, and also another one circuit breaker which connected between the emergency generator to the emergency switchboard. So that the interlock which connected the two circuit breaker on and off. This is the wiring diagram of the emergency switchboard. So I am already said that our emergency switchboard will be splitted into two voltage separation. One is 440 volt, another one is the 220 volt. 440 volt and 220 volt. See that the main switchboard supply is come from the which connected to the 440. The interlock. This is a switch which connected between the main switchboard and the emergency switchboard. This is an emergency generator. So the emergency switchboard will be split into two types: 440 volt and a 220 volt. For 440 volt, we give the main heavy load such as sprinkle pumps, fire pumps, and fuel oil supply and booster pump, emergency bilge pump. These are the heavy load which gives supply for. It's also it's an emergency. It's an 24 hours. It will be in working condition. So that's why we give the 440 volt for this load. And 220 volt version means navigational lights, radio communication, and bridge equipments. For these purposes, there is a 220 volt is enough. So we give the 220 volt for this kind of the load. So this is the main. It's an emergency switchboard. The emergency switchboard gets supply from the emergency generator, while main generator will be in failure condition. Otherwise, the main switchboard has to give supply to the emergency switchboard. Then, you through this emergency switchboard, the load will be get supply from the emergency switchboard. Okay. When the failure will be occur, means the steering gear cut off, it will cut the load open type, and the interlock will be in open between the main switchboard to the emergency switchboard, then the emergency generator will be on and give supply to the emergency switchboard. And from the 220 volt, some voltage will be in transformer through the rectifier. That means the AC will be converted into DC to the battery backup. From onwards, we get the battery backup in full condition. So, because from the battery, we give the some of the battery backup to the DC load, and also to starting the emergency generator also, we get the supply from the battery. This is also one of the starting purposes of the emergency, we can see in later. And then low voltage system and safety systems like the alarm and control system also get from the battery, because this alarm and control systems are work under the DC load. That's why we can, first of all, the 220 volt will be transformed. That means it will be stepped down into a low voltage. That voltage will be converted into DC through the rectifier, and then converted into that DC will be charged in the battery. That battery supply will give for the emergency lighting, alarm and control system like the low voltage system. So it is a very wiring diagram of the emergency switchboard and the working condition of the emergency switchboard. So this is the emergency switchboard distributions. There is a lot of the load which connected for the emergency switchboard. What are the loads are connected from the emergency switchboard, sir? The main thing, only the important things only connected from the emergency switchboard. We get the supply 24 hours supply. That's only we are connected on emergency switchboard. Okay. So these are the emergency bilge pump, sprinkler system, one of the steering gear, navigation equipment, and radio communications. From the load, from this application, we are easily understandable. So the radio, navigation equipment and radio communication is very important for to run the ship. Okay, so the radio communication and navigation is 24 hours. It will be in on condition only. If it be off, means it will be very dangerous to the captain. So we give the 24/7 supply to the steering gear, navigational equipments, and radio communications like that. And importantly, the for battery backup. So we also use the DC backup also for emergency lighting and also radar. So there is, they are give the DC supply only. So from the DC supply we get the emergency switchboard only. So the transitional emergency power battery, low power DC system battery like alarm and control system are get are the, these are the important thing are get from the supply from only in emergency switchboard only. Next we see about the requirement of the emergency generator, because I'm already repeated once again and repeatedly many of them I can repeat it. Emergency generator working under an emergency situation, in any accidental case only the main generator will be power be off, or in any blackout condition while the chief any cadet or misconnection of the any parallel connection between the two generator, on the time the blackout condition is taken place. So immediately within the 45 second the emergency generator will be in taken off. Okay, so we thought it will not be taken off means it very dangerous to our ship. So we lost a lot of the signals and communications. We want the 24 hours power supply. Okay, so we have a lot of the main requirement and some regulations in for emergency generator. What are the main requirements are? The electric power providing generator shall be driven the suitable prime mover having the independent auxiliary system which may consist of fuel, ventilation, lubrication, cooling. So these are the main thing for working of the main generator, main requirement of the generator. It has to be independent, not with combined with another generators. And the fuel used in the emergency generator, the prime mover must have the flash point of greater than 43 degrees Celsius. So the fuel must be in the 43 degrees Celsius, and the prime mover of the emergency generator shall be started automatically once the main source of the electrical power supply fails. If the emergency generator does not start or not take of the load of the emergency switchboard connection, an indication shall be given in the engine room or at manned control section. This is also very important. If they are not the emergency generator not working on the proper time means it's also very critical manner, that signal is directly go to the main switchboard, otherwise there is no one be alert. So for quick action there is a signal which connection on the main switchboard to known the chief engineers. Next we see about the starting of the emergency generator, because it's a very very important the characteristics is the starting. Without we are knowing the starting, the emergency generator, the study of the emergency generator is a waste. So the starting of the emergency generator is a very very important, and it's a repeated question, important question also. So normally the emergency generator, the starting will classify into three types: battery start, hydraulic start and automatic start. Due to the battery backup, we are easily on off to, when you press the button on, the due to the battery backup easily on. If the battery will be not be in backup, we have a lower battery means next we go for the hydraulic or manual start. To put there is an hydraulic piston to give the hydraulic pressure to the generator, and from that we can start the generator. Next one, automatic start. It is an automatic start when the switch will be interlocked, will be cut off from the main switchboard, then the start immediately emergency generator will be on due to the relay circuit. So we can, these are the three kind of the starting purpose we can see in elaborate in deep briefly in one by one. First of all we can see about the battery start. What are the procedure to be to start the emergency generator by battery? Because the procedure is very very important. There are steps. So the from the initial step to final step, it's in a step by step only we can run on the emergency generator. Otherwise if the emergency generator not be on, it gives some trouble or any problem, it's begin to be a repair. So in a secure manner, in a sequence manner only we can start the emergency generator through the battery. What are the procedure are? First of all, go to the emergency generator room and find the panel of the emergency generator. Put the switch on the test mode from the automatic mode. I'm already said the emergency start, while we are start only on the emergency, otherwise in every Saturday the cadet will be start the emergency generator for maintenance purposes. So before going to the testing for maintenance purposes, that's a testing mode, we go to switch the on the test mode from the automatic mode. There is a panel. Nowadays there is a new technology, there is an LCD touch screen also in the power panel. I can see if your time permits, we can see some videos of the working operation of the emergency switchboard, emergency generator in the end of the session. In the switch panel, there is a mode will be taken place, automatic mode, test mode. So when we go to start for testing purposes, we go to press the test mode and off the automatic mode, and the generator will start automatically and will not come on load. So under that, in test mode, then there is no any load will connected on the emergency generator. And the check the voltage and frequency in the meter, how much of the voltage and frequency will be in the meter of the emergency generator. We must know about the voltage and frequency. And keep the generator running for 10 to 15 minutes and check the exhaust temperature and other parameters. For heat transfer, we also very much know, we are very important. So we must run emergency generator on 10 to 15 minutes for the testing purposes, not only 5 minutes or below 10 minutes. And from the running condition, we also check the exhaust pump, how much of the smoke will be outside, out of the dust will be created. We also can check it on that time also. And then next, check the sump level. From the sump, we can find out how much of the fuel are kept under the sump, and oil, how much of the oil will be placed in the sump level. And for stopping, and finally, we can fully check it and test it. We can stop the generator, put the switch manual, and then stop the generator. So I'm already said there's a stop button also in that panel. We can simply press the stop button. Then the emergency generator will be off. This is the recent technology. There is no any manual work. Just press the button in the touch screen and then off the button and change the test mode. And also after the off the button, we can press the automatically start. Don't forget to not press the automatically start. Otherwise, if any emergency situation will come, the emergency generator not be work out, not be in started or not be in running condition. So before going to the test, we off the automatic start and put the test mode, and after testing the testing condition of the emergency generator, we can off the test mode and on the automatic start mode. It's very, very important. And next we can go for the hydraulic starting. Next method of the starting is in hydraulic starting or manual starting. When the battery backup will be very low, we go for the hydraulic starting. In previous in 10 years or 15 years back, we only use the hydraulic start only due to give the hydraulic pressure, and we give the start that prime mover and the generator will be start. We can go to the procedure for the hydraulic start. Out the switch in manual mode as stated above and check the pressure gauge for sufficient oil pressure. So hydraulic only under the working under and then pressure. So first we check the pressure gauge to he has sufficient pressure or not, sufficient oil pressure or not. Then open the valve from accumulator to the generator to release the pressure, to open the valve from the accumulator and push the spring loader valve, and the generator should start. After that, there is a spring loader, there is a piston, and also the simple piston also have, there is a bar piston also have. That depends upon our ship, various of the load we are used for hydraulic pressure. Some of the ship which has a high like the piston like this manner, some of the piston in the simple hand manner only due to the difference of the technologies. So the push the spring loader well and the generator should start, and check the voltage and the frequency of the generator. Kept the generator running for 10 to 15 minutes, the same like the procedure of the battery, and then check the exhaust temperature and other parameter, and check the sump level. And for stopping, use the manual stop button from the panel. Here also there is a manual stop switch in the generator for the hydraulic start. There is an off condition, then generator will be off. After stopping the generator, the pressurize the hydraulic accumulator to desired pressure. So check the again after stop, we can check the pressure in the hydraulic accumulator, and close the valve from accumulator to the generator. Before starting, we can open the valve from accumulator to generator, and before closing, close the valve from accumulator to generator. So it's a very important method. For battery starting, what we do? Put the test mode and off the automatic mode, and end of the session, end of the testing, off the test mode and on the automatic mode in battery starting. In the hydraulic starting, open the valve from accumulator to generator, and we can test and we can get the testing after 10 to 15 minutes, and we get after the certification of the emergency generator in good condition, and we finally we can stop the generator and close the valve from accumulator to generator. This is the main step of the procedure of the hydraulic starting. We forget this, it's a very very critical condition, or go to the repair, or any it's not under the stop with the emergency generator not to be start on the emergency situation. Next we can see about the automatic start. What is the procedure of the automatic start? So the final starting procedure, final starting method is an automatic start. It's a very simple method for automatic start, but it has a battery backup in full condition. Without battery condition, it's not to be start in automatically. And also in rare cases only we are used. So the automatic start is very important and very efficient also. What is an automatic start and what is the difference between both battery start and hydraulic start is then? For automatic start, we know that there is a breaker which connected in the emergency switchboard and the main switchboard, and there are also interlock provided due to which the emergency generator and the main power of the ship cannot to supply together. Therefore, we simulate by opening the breaker from the tie line, which can be done from the MSB or the ESB panel. After opening the breaker, the emergency generator starts automatically with the help of battery and will supply essential power to the machinery and pump connected to the ESB. There is no any on switch or off switch. Just simply we can interlock, that the interlock switch will be in closed or open, the emergency generator will be on. I am already, once again I can repeat it, in this lecture I can repeat it more time. The emergency switchboard get the, now in normal condition, the emergency switchboard get supply from the main switchboard through main generator only. When the blackout condition or any critical situation occur, the main generator power will be failure. Then there's the supply from the main switchboard to the emergency switchboard to be in cut off through the interlock switch. Then the emergency generator will be automatically on and give the supply to the emergency switchboard. Okay, that's procedure, that condition is an automatic start. If there is a delay which start the emergency generator, when the interlock will be open in between the main switchboard to the emergency switchboard, automatically within the 45 second the emergency generator will be on. That's automatic condition, is the working procedure for the automatic start. And now again put the switch to the manual mode to the stop the generator. After we solve the problem on the main generator, we can stop the emergency generator to stop the manual mode, and press the stop and the generator will be stopped. So from the lecture we can see about what are the topics we are covered in this lecture. First of all, we can see about the what is the main power distribution on the ship. In this power distribution, what is the role of the emergency generator, what is meant by emergency generator, and what are the maintenance, and what are the procedure to start of the emergency generator. These are the topics we are covered. Next, the main thing of the emergency generator is then the emergency is a regulation, because under the DG shipping, under the regulation is very very important. The emergency generator, which also we are working under the SOLAS regulation, because everyone know about the SOLAS regulation. The SOLAS is the safety of life at sea. This is an international standard or international organization which monitoring this ship, which establishes the safety measures in the construction equipment and operation of the merchant ship. So without any solar regulation, we are now design means the ship will be in neglected. So under the solar regulation only we are design the ship. Okay, so the solar regulation is a very very important. So again I can say, what is in by the SOLAS? The SOLAS is the full acronym of safety of life at sea. Okay, under this regulation we can see about the emergency generator. So emergency generator also there is some requirement under this regulation in the ship. What are the regulation means? The emergency generator and emergency switchboard of the ship should be located above the uppermost continuous deck, not in the engine room, bottom engine room. It is only placed on the uppermost deck, away from the machinery space behind the collision bulkhead, and the main switchboard of the ship should not interface the supply, control and the distribution of the emergency power. It's very very important. There is no any supply for the emergency power to the from the main switchboard. So these are the main regulation, and also we can see about the next few lines of the solar regulation over the emergency switch, emergency generator. So the main another important things of the solar's regulation for emergency generator is that the power should be capable operating with a list up to 22 off degree and a trim up to 10 degree. So emergency source of the power should be capable of list up to 22 off degree and a trim up to 10 degree. These are the main regulation. Next, it should be independent fuel supply having the flash point not less than 43 degrees Celsius. I am already, we can see in the requirement of the emergency generator this same point, that the independent fuel for emergency generator, not for the main generator fuel. This case and separately we are kept the emergency generator fuel under the temperature, flash point temperature of less than 43 degrees Celsius. And it should be capable the power the period of 18 hours for cargo ships and 36 hours for the passenger ships. So before designing to the ship to be implemented to the sail or to the ship, we are checking the emergency generator how much of the hours will be to be in working condition. So for it's a very very main regulation, compulsorily for cargo ship the emergency generate the power from emergency generator which carry the 18 hours. And for passenger ship, it carries the 36 hours. It's very very important. And the emergency generator should start at the 0 degree Celsius temperature. Fall below, then there should be a heating arrangement. So up to the 0 degree Celsius, the generator will be in on condition, because the ship goes in both summer hot area and also cold area. So the emergency generator should start at 0 degree Celsius onwards. But below 0 degree Celsius goes to minus means. So we want to be in a heating arrangement, separate heating arrangement for starting the emergency generator. And the next important regulation of the emergency generator which is governed by a solar system, the emergency generator should be command load automatically within 45 seconds after the failure of the main power supply. It's also very very important thing. 45 seconds, within 45 seconds the emergency generator to be in on when the power will be switched off. Okay. Without the seconds will be increased means under the solar regulation the ship will be in not in condition. So they reject that, they cancel that agreement also. If the emergency generator fails to command the load, indication should be given to the emergency switchboard, and it should have the two different starting arrangement. The primary may be battery fully charged at the time, and the secondary may be the pneumatic and hydraulic. So I am already discussed about the starting of the emergency generator. So first of all, we are use the battery only, because within the fraction of second the battery backup only start the emergency generator very quickly. If the battery also have no certain sufficient backup means, we go for the manual or any pneumatic or hydraulic starting, for the providing the three consecutive start within the 30 minutes and one start within the 12 minutes. These are the main regulation to starting the emergency generator. So that's all of the topic of the emergency generator. So from the topic we can see about the entire area of the emergency generator. Emergency generator, what is the emergency generator and what is the emergency switchboard, how they power to be generator, and what are the main requirement of the emergency generator, and how what are the starting types of the classification of the starting and its procedure, and finally what are the solar regulation will be taken under the emergency generator, we can cover in the entire topic. So thank you for giving this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.